So, what happened, Susan? Something happened.
Yes, for the past 2.5 weeks, I feel as if the spirit husband has returned. Like I've been having such strange dreams, and just generally in the physical, I felt an overwhelming sense of paranoia and I don't know, lack of self-esteem and so on.
Okay, now
I don't
understand
know really
that.
how to explain it.
Okay, now I understand that part, but what happened? You open a door. There's a door that you open.
Yes, I think it's because I was having a conversation with a friend and she had asked like if I was sexually active. And I said no I'm
She just
I
come
said no
out.
I'm not and she
She just came out and asked if you were sexually active. Now you know
Yes,
that was
we
the
were talking
devil.
about like it is. Like she was talking about one of the guys she's courting and then she had asked and then I said no and she said
The conference has been locked.
black man.
Okay, now you say that again because I had to lock the conference and it tuned your voice out. So could you
Yeah,
repeat what you said?
she said you need to get yourself a strong black man. And she said, oh, you don't know what you're missing and
Oh,
things like
that
that. And
was
from that point on, I realized I've been having some lustful thoughts.
Yeah, that injected lust right into you. Because
Yes, yes. And it's
the moment she asked about if you were having sex, you should have ended the conversation and hung up the phone. So I refuse to talk to you.
No, it was face to face. I
Well,
actually laughed it off.
that was even better. You could tell her face to face, I refuse to talk to you because this talk is not of the Holy Spirit and I refuse to listen. But because you didn't, right through your hearing, that's when that spirit of lust traveled back into your ears. Through hearing that and not and refusing to put it in her place.
Oh my God.
And then from there, what happened?
From there on, it's as if I've been having very, very strange dreams. Last time I can't remember, but I can remember snippets of the dreams. And I know it's as if, and sometimes there's a woman following me, sometimes it's a man. And the thing is, the woman, she has exactly the same birthmark as me. I woke up from the dream remembering, like, oh my God, she looked just like me. But she had on makeup and she had the same birthmark because I have a birthmark on my face. And I was thinking, wow, what is this? So I can't remember if I prayed about it or not, but I've just been having very strange dreams and so on. I've been led to lust and so on and so forth. And also there's also been the issue of pornography and so on.
And then also masturbation as well.
Yes.
Okay, because that through that lust, the lust opened the door for spirit. The husband come back in, and he brought in pornography and masturbation.
Yes, it's as if I don't have control over my mind or emotions.
Right, because that spirit is back
Yes.
into the house. But
And
what?
also I've realized like in the physical realm, I don't know what it is, but especially among females, as I walk on the street, it's like as if I feel the spirit of lust from them. I know like some sort of homosexual spirit. I don't know if
Lesbian.
they've put a face. Yes. I don't know if that spirit has come upon me through the
Yeah.
spirit husband, or I really can't understand it.
Yeah, that they those demons all work together, come in a bundle. That's that
Oh my
woman.
God.
That's that woman that you saw in the in your dream that looked like you. That is a lesbian spirit that is
Oh
following
my
you.
God.
And that's why I come when you When you see women, you know, you're looking at them through the eyes of lust. That's that lesbian spirit, and
Oh my
it
God.
put on your appearance. It put on your appearance because
Yes.
it's in you. So what you can learn from this, Susan, is that you must not fear. You must speak truth, regardless of who it is. If they're not speaking the words of God to build you up in Christ Jesus, you have to come out bluntly and tell them, no, you refuse to listen to such language. I did a message on Holy Ghost Fire talk about a couple of hours ago, instruction for Christian living, and the Lord was warning us about our relationships. Satan is really deceiving us and pulling us into his kingdom through and by relationships. And those relationships are not godly relationships, you know. So make sure you, when I post the message on YouTube, make sure you listen to it, you know.
Okay.
So we're talking about your life in Christ Jesus. This person has rejected God. They have rejected God, and all manner of evil is in their heart, and they do all manner of evil, and they speak all manner of evil, but you don't have to listen. So where you messed up is when you didn't stop her. You did not stop her. Do you think that someone just come in my face and talk like that, I would stop them? I will. And then you have to do that too. Ask the Lord to give you holy boldness. She was bold enough to ask you that question. You should have been bold enough to say, get out of my face, because I don't like such talk. Because that's not the Holy Ghost. That was the demons in her. So she was bold enough.
From that moment on, immediately, I started feeling those lustful thoughts.
Right. Because you didn't reject her. You didn't push her away. You stood there listening like, I don't want to hurt her feelings. I'm going to stay right here. No. No. You better. Because she needs to be shaken. And make known that the life that she lives in is going to end up in destruction and also death, spiritual and physically. Because the only, even when you marry, the only man that we truly need is Jesus Christ. Is Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Amen. 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 So again, you learn from it. And you see how subtle the devil is in returning. Now who would have thought that he could return back into you through that transaction, that dealing with that young lady? Because we got to be careful. You know, who we yield our ears to, you know, if that conversation is ungodly, you know, we can't stand up on that conversation. I know I don't want to hear that. And I've been like that for a long time. You know, sometimes you be put in situations where you can't say nothing, but you can get up and get out. I walk out. Why did she leave? That's what I said. Why did she leave? Because I don't want to hear such filth. I don't want to contaminate my ear, because demon spirit will attach that way. But God's going to set you totally free again. You know, he's a good God. You know, when we see the error of our ways and we repent, sin no more, he always faithful in forgiving us and also delivering us. So from this day forth, you continue to stay in obedience. You learn from that mistake. Say, okay, devil, you got it. But no more. And continue to trust the Holy Spirit that you be cautious. You don't need such friends. They are really not friends. You know, we have to disassociate ourselves from people who are not.
Yeah, she even invited me this past Saturday to a nightclub, and I declined.
See, that is not no friend. Somebody like that, you have to keep that from their children or daughters. So make sure you listen to that message that I just produced today when I post on YouTube. Mm-hmm. After I hang up with you, I'm going to go ahead and post on YouTube, Instruction for Christian Living. You know, that's exactly what our brethren did in the early church. They were associating themselves with people who was in the Word. In the world, pagans, children of darkness, who were separated from God, and they did all manner of evil against God. And so here God's children had connected themselves with them, and they started doing evil too, because those spirits transferred into them. You see, God's word is an example for you and I. You know, my heart is saddened for that young lady, because she don't know the danger that she's in.
Yes.
Yes, she do not.
You know, actually, yesterday after I had sent you the email, before I had prayed one of your prayers. It was just a general prayer about prayer for spiritual spouse and spiritual friends in brackets. I don't know, it's one of your older videos. And I ended up manifesting. Mm-hmm. Like my body was contorting as a snake, and I also spat out, I don't know. And I was yawning very heavily.
Mm-hmm.
And after the yawning stopped, it's as if my mouth was just open wide. I don't know how to explain that sort of manifestation.
Yes, some of those spirits left. When you started that yawning, open your mouth and yawning, some of those spirits left. But that strong man, that spirit husband, is still in there, and that's where you need help, you know.
Yes, and then I went to bed, and I had a dream that, I don't know, I could see, it was as if there were people, it was like a town of Sodom and Gomorrah, but the people I saw, they were half human, and then the legs especially were coiled very long, about over 2 meters, I don't know, over 6'4". And they were sleeping with animals and so on. But the top part was half human, and then the bottom was like, I don't know, like the DNA helix. The legs were like that, but they were not legs because it was not natural.
That's bestiality too, because I'll tell you, all those sexual demons come lumped, grouped in together, and Lord was letting you see the sexual demons that have taken over Sodom and Gomorrah, and God destroyed them two cities. He destroyed those two cities. Because they were so evil, and the people refused to repent. They did not desire to repent. It was just an infestation of evil, of evil. Just like when a person's house gets infested with roaches, where it was an infestation of evil, those sexual demons, you know, sleeping with humans, sleeping with animals, all manner of sin. And that's the type of spirit that had entered you. You know, if you didn't call on
God,
if you had didn't call on God and to help you, that's exactly what you would end up doing. Because you would be surprised that many people who have rejected God and they have these sexual demons in them, and you think they have cats and dogs as pets, but you don't know that they actually are their lover. They are actually having sex with those animals. Because of this, spirits, the demon spirits that are in them, you know. So we just praise God.
Oh my God!
That you know, call out to Him, because you refuse to serve Satan and refuse to continue to be in that situation. And again, Susan, just learn from that mistake. You learn from that mistake.
Amen. Okay.
You have a testimony to help others, to show others too, that you have to be careful of your friends. You know, light just don't fellowship with darkness. Darkness don't fellowship with light. According to the word of God, bad company will corrupt good character, good behavior. That's what the word of God says. So therefore, we have to we have to watch who we choose as our friend. And this is, again, this confirmation to the message that I brought today. Confirmation. So I'm going to pray, and by faith, I'm going to speak a disconnection on this earth, and it's Jesus Christ in the heavenly who's going to once again disconnect you from every spirit that is not of Him. Okay?
Amen.
And we thank you, Father. So, Father, in Jesus' name, again, I thank you for this opportunity to minister your love and your grace and mercy to your daughter, Susan. I thank you, Father, that you never leave her, you never forsake her, and you never give up on her, Father. And, Father, she's not giving up on you. And I thank you, Father, again, that every plan, person, idea that you have to take place in her life and bringing only glory to your Son, Jesus Christ, it shall be fulfilled right here on this earth. And I ask you, Father, continue to give her wisdom and revelation of who she truly is in your Son, Jesus, and also who Jesus is in her. And I thank you for keeping her, filling her with your spirit, and keeping her to the day of redemption. Thank you, Father, for setting the angels around her right now, Father, protecting her always, Father. I just thank you for your love and grace and mercy and compassion that you have for her, Father. But, Father, I thank you for cleaning your house for true worship, Father, cleaning her mind, you're cleaning her will, you're cleaning her emotions, and you're cleaning her body, as well as her dreams, Father. You're even cleaning her dreams right now, Father. I thank you, Father, even cleaning her vision, the vision that you had given her, Father. I thank you for clean vision, Father. I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, for just keeping her. Continue, Father, strengthen her each and every day in your word so that she can help others in bringing them out of the darkness to the marvelous light, Father. I just thank you, Father, that she shall be a mighty example to show forth your glory, Father, upon this earth, Father. I just thank you, Father, for your plan and purpose and idea for her. And I thank you, Father, and in Jesus' name, I speak on this earth that every door that the enemy have closed off to her, I open those doors by the blood of Jesus. And every door that the enemy have opened that the Lord did not open, I close those doors in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for your presence because you said when two or three of us come together in your name, you here with us. And whatever we bind and loose on this earth, you bind and you loose in the heaven. And I thank you, Father, for the angels that is holding that phone right now, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. And I, Father, I thank you because you said whatever I bind and loose on this earth, you are the one who bind and loose in the heavens. So I take authority in the name of Jesus. You spirit snake, you get out of her body. Come out of her body now. Pat your nose and get out of her body in Jesus' name. Spirit husband, pat your nose. Pat prono, masturbation, lesbian, bestiality, every spirit that belongs to you, I command you to come out of God's house. You come out of her mind. You come out of her mind. You come out of her will. You come out of her emotions. And you come out of her body. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire burning, Holy Ghost. Burn in Jesus' name. Set her mind completely ablaze by your fire. Everything in her mind that have exalted itself against the knowledge of Jesus Christ, burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, burn in her mind. Burn all matter of darkness that's rushing out and dormantly in her mind. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost fire, continue to set ablaze her will. Burn, Holy Spirit, all manner of darkness that's lurking and hiding dormantly in her will. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn everything in her will that has exalted itself against the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Burn, 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 burn in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, continue to celebrate her emotion. Search and destroy darkness, search and hide and dormantly in her emotion. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn everything in her emotion that has exalted itself against the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn in her emotion. Burn, shut her emotion by your mighty fire. Fire the Holy Ghost, set her emotion ablaze. In Jesus' mighty name, Holy Ghost fire continue to burn in her body from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Burn, burn in her body, burn in her belly, burn all manner of snakes and eggs and a darkness lying in her belly, burn in her mouth, down her throat, burn up her nostril, even burn in her ear, burn in her private area. Burn, Holy Spirit, burn. Spirit that have exalted itself against the knowledge of God in her body, burn in Jesus' mighty name. Burn in Jesus' mighty name. Set her body ablaze. Holy Ghost fire burn. Burn on her body everywhere that was placed or more, known or unknown to her. Burn by your fire in Jesus' mighty name. By faith, I take the God scissors and I cut and detach her. From the ungodly covenant of adoption with witchcraft, I detach her from that evil spirit, marriage in the spirit realm, from the evil spirit children, that evil spirit family, I disconnect her from darkness in the name of Jesus, for the blood of Jesus separates her. Blood of Jesus separates her. The blood of Jesus separates her from you. Lucifer and cut her. Pacquiao, so get out in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, Susan, your mind, be free in your mind. You be free in your will. You be free in your emotions. You be free. fear your God, serve and worship the Lord thy God, and him only do you serve in spirit and truth, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, fill her with your spirit. Fill her mind. Fill her will. Fill her emotions and fill her body, Father, with your spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I also pray for Susan Howe. Holy Ghost fire, go. Search and destroy at her house. Go in every room. Search and destroy darkness that is lurking, hiding, running in every closet, in every corner, crack and crevice of the room, under every bed, over the bed, around the bed. Burn by your fire. Leave no space untouched at her house. Even burn outside the house. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn on top of the ground, under the ground, under the house. Burn those objects that were planted there that is known or unknown to her. Set ablaze darkness in Jesus' name by your fire in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for setting this captive free. Thank you, Father, for filling her with your spirit, Father. Thank you, Father, for clothing her with your righteousness, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, once again for setting your daughter totally free, Father. We glorify you. We magnify you. We exalt your name forever, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for leaving nothing on her body untouched, but fill her in every area, Father. Every place there's a hole and an opening on her body, Father, fill it with your spirit. Fill it with your spirit, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. Glory to your holy name. Thank you, Lord. Amen, amen, amen. Susan?
Amen.
Yeah, you're free, baby.
Mm-hmm.
Praise him.
Amen. Thank you.
And thank him.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Once again, he's such a gracious and good God. Glory to him.
Amen.
Glory
to God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Lord. Thank you, Lord, for not giving up on us.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. So what was going on? Because something was going on over there.
It's something I've never experienced before. It's as if fire was all over my body and I couldn't stand it. I wanted to pull my hair out and I was moving like a snake.
I was
coughing and just
just
heavily breathing, and I was compelled to the floor, and I just felt fire all over my body.
Glory.
Just heat.
Thank you, G. That the Holy Ghost fire. Your snake had you wrapped up and tied up. Have you ever seen the documentaries when a python has wrapped its cord itself around its an object?
Yes.
That's the way snake.
Yes, yes.
That's the way snake had you. That snake symbolized spirit of, spirit of love. A spirit of lust. Those sexual demons. And but the Holy Spirit, as I was praying to the Father, that's when it started, when the Lord started it. And I heard that snake, and when that snake started making that noise, because even the prayer that I presented to the Father, that snake couldn't stand the prayer. Couldn't stand the prayer.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Lord, we just thank you. We just thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Glory.
Thank you, Lord.
You know, dear
glory to God.
I'm talking to them. I'm going to share this. I'm talking to them who are listening in. This is no joke. You know, don't play. Don't be listening to these sessions and thinking that they are false or these people are not don't have demons in them. First of all, then you think they are not set free. Dear, you better stop. Because remember now, those spirits are gone and they're looking for somewhere else to go. And you sit there and you hear the grace of God upon a person's life, and you have the audacity to go out and say, oh, there was nothing wrong with them. And that prayer didn't do a thing. Well, you would be a perfect candidate for those demons to jump right into. This is no game. It is no joke. God set this young lady free. He set all of them free. He set all of them free. He has his reason why he allows sometimes demons to lead quietly, and sometimes he don't allow them to lead quietly. He has his reason. for doing that. You know, if you was right there where Susan is, you would have exactly seen with your own eyes those demons coming out of her. Because even though I'm on this phone line, I knew there was a lot of rumbling and shaking going on over there. Because those demons did not want to leave. But they knew they had to leave because Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost is a consuming fire. And they had to get out and go. Because Susan belongs to God. Her body is the temple for the Holy Ghost. So praise the Lord. So he done it, Susan. Thank you, Lord.
Amen, amen.
You have a powerful testimony. Now, Susan, the Lord will tell you now. You knew the demon that was in you, and they are gone. They are the same demon. Are the same demon that's in that young lady. Said they are the same demon that's in that young lady. She's not getting no peace, no rest at night. During the day, especially at night, but she's not telling anybody. So when that spirit through her mentioned what it said to you, that was just a lie.
Amen.
It was a lie. So you keep her in prayer. You pray that God do whatever it takes for her to turn and come to him. Pray.
Amen.
And the next time when she come and try to hold a conversation, you need to share with her the goodness of God. Share with her the goodness of God. Do your part in sharing. Now, don't worry about if a person's going to receive it or not. You know, that's not our responsibility if a person's going to receive what we say. Jesus didn't tell us that they're going to believe or they weren't going to believe. He told us what to do. He said, go and share what great things God has done for you. And we allow the Spirit to do his work, his conviction work. That's the Holy Spirit's responsibility to do that convicting work of sin, righteousness, and judgment. Our responsibility is to share what great things God has done so they can hear. And then when they hear it, that's when the Holy Spirit would do his convicting work. Now, don't believe it.
Amen.
Don't be the devil deception in getting you not to even share a testimony by saying where they're not going to receive it, they're not going to believe it. I ain't concerned myself with that. That's not my business. That's the Holy Spirit business. That's not what God told me to do. He didn't tell me to make them believe me. He told me, gave me specific command and to share what great things he had done for me. The other is the work of the Holy Spirit. So you share what great things God has done for you. We must watch our relationships. Be careful who we connect ourselves to, because demons do transfer through unhealthy connection as far as relationship. Unhealthy relationship, demons will transfer. You see how that thing transferred was transferring right into your ears, and you had no clue that spirit snake was just crawling right in your ears as you were yielding your ears to that young girl's conversation. You had no idea. But when those spirits start acting and reacting, then you knew, they're in me. And it was the grace of God who brought to your remembrance how it got in. So you probably said, well, why this thing get in me? And Lord brought to your remembrance. Remember you had that conversation with that girl? You should have stopped it right there and just left her present. No, because you don't want to hurt her feelings. You stood right there. And that's what the devil wants. You know, so praise God. You are totally free in Jesus' name. And your place where you live and stay is free as well. Now,
amen.
Did she give you anything in any object, anything to keep?
No, she didn't. She didn't.
Okay. Make sure you don't accept gifts from her.
No, you've reminded me now. I remember yesterday. Actually, this morning, after I told you I had prayed the prayer, the demon actually spoke and said he came in through food.
Okay.
And I recall that she usually used to buy me food, like buy me lunch and things like this.
What?
And we would have our conversations. Yes, always. She would always offer.
She will always offer to buy your lunch.
Mm-hmm.
I heard that. So what's wrong with that? It's a lot. Because people chant over things, that they chant curses. When a person's a servant of Satan, and you accept their free gifts, whereby them being a servant of Satan, whatever that gift is within themselves, they are cursing it, and then they handing it to you, and you receive it. You receive it. You know, you looking at their kindness, but it ain't no kind. That's why we need to inquire of the Lord in everything, no matter how small or how great. We need to inquire.
Oh my God.
Of the Lord. And so when she, every time she would suggest to buy you something, you said, oh sure, that gave her opportunity to the demon in her to curse that food. And so when you waited, and that's when the demons enter more and more into you. You know, just because something's free, dear heart, don't be accepting things just because it's free. You know, that everything is free, that's not a gift from God. Oh, God bless me. No, you better inquire the Lord. Lord, is this blessing truly of you? What's the motive behind?
Oh, my God.
What's the motive behind this blessing, Lord Jesus? Inquire the Lord, and the Lord will tell you. He just say, take it. They're doing it from the kindness of their heart. Or he'll say, no, don't receive it. Because their motive is to trap you. Now, again, you'd be surprised of group witches who are keeping themselves secret as far as being a witch. You will just never know. If the Holy Spirit don't let you know, you'll never know. And again, when you accept their free thing, you are actually is accepting that a curse, because they are cursing those things.
My
daughter, you know, she got a little daughter, and she goes and buy her things, and she had learned this. She learned to acquire the Lord in everything, even going to the store and purchasing things, special clothes or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
She always, the Lord told her when she get to always pray over it. And the reason why is because when things are in the store, all kinds amount of people go in and touch those clothing. They put their hands on those clothes. And the spirits that are in them will attach itself to those clothing. So the Lord told her to always pray over things that she purchased. Always pray over that she purchased. And she did that. But one time she forgot to do that. And she bought something for her little girl. And all of a sudden, the little girl, it's like she was afraid. It was like she would see something and she would just bare her head in her mother's stomach, like she was hiding from something. And she couldn't understand her actions. So she asked the Lord, Lord, what's wrong with my daughter? Why is she behaving this way? And the Lord brought to her attention. Remember, you went to the store and bought her, I don't know if it was a toy or outfit. But whatever, what he said, you remember, you didn't even pray over it. You just assumed it was okay and brought it home. She said, Lord, that is so true. Forgive me. And she said she went and she prayed over it. And then she rebuked the spirit that was attached to it. She rebuked it and commanded it to get out the house. And then she noticed her little girl was a lot better. You see?
Oh, my God.
Think about it, Susan. You got all kinds of amount of people going shopping, putting their hands on different clothing. You know, I think I'm going to buy this, but they change their mind, or they're just touching it. You know, the spirit that's in them, it will transfer on them clothing. So you have to pray. Even if you go and try a garment on, before you try that garment on, you need to pray over that garment. First,
yes.
Wear that garment, because you don't know who already slipped that garment on. You know, that's why, again, we need to acquire the Lord in everything. It don't matter how small or how great.
Amen.
You see? So that's how the devil that you know certain devils enter into you if it was through those three meals that you thought was a blessing from God. That it really was a
yes.
Really was stated. Now what you should have done, you say, oh yes, I thank you for buying my lunch. Then before you even started eating, you said, hold up, I got to say my blessing. And said, not real loud, but said where she could hear. And then you bless that food. You pray to your Heavenly Father, he blessed that food. And if you have done that, mm-hmm. would have done that, and you would have looked at her, you would have saw the devil in her would have gotten so angry. Would have gotten so angry. Because that prayer would have canceled out Satan's plan. His purpose, his
yes.
idea. That's what we're supposed to do. Pray. Let the devil hear us pray. Ask not him, the Father, to bless it, to make it holy. Cover it with the blood, precious blood of your Son, Jesus. Help it to be nourishment unto my body. Oh, if you would have done that, Sue, I'm telling you, that demon in her, you would have actually, that thing would have got angry with you. Because, again, it would have canceled out its purpose, plan, idea.
Yes.
So help it to do in the future. Someone want to buy you lunch, say, okay, sure. And then when they do, I got to say my blessing first. And you let them hear you bless, ask the Father to bless that food. Just take your time. Don't close your eyes. Now, when you pray, let me give you a spiritual nugget here, Susan. When you're out in public and you pray, do not close your eyes. You watch and pray. Scripture said watch as well as pray. Don't be closing your eyes. You watch and pray. You got your eyes open and you're looking around, being attentive to your environment, and you are praying. That's the way you pray. Don't be still and put your head down and close your eyes. I learned that from a great man of God called Lester Sumrall. He said he was traveling in India in the train, and he noticed that there was a man with a monkey on his shoulder, and there was a priest in front of him. And it was time for this priest to eat. So the priest bowed his head and closed his eyes. And as he was praying, the monkey that was on the man's shoulder that was in front of him stole his food. he said, that's when he learned when the word of God say, watch as well as pray.
Amen.
You watch as well. And look, when that man said, his food won't there, and the monkey acted like he did not know what was going on. Watch as well as that's what to do. Okay. That concludes everything that you is interested in purchasing and buying. Don't matter how small or how great it is. You cry the Lord about it first, and then you pray over it. Just stop.
Amen.
Things for granted. Just assume that things are okay. Assume what people give you is okay. No. Mm-mm. You inquire of the Lord, and he said, keep it. Then you pray over it. You pray. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's done in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
You're welcome, Susan. You're welcome. You know, when I received your email and you told me what was going on, I said, Susan, wow. Because the Lord told us when unclean spirits leave and they end up coming back, you're worse off the second time than you were before. And what I read, you was more worse off this time than you was when you first called me. I was like, wow. I said, no, Lord. Susan,
yes.
Susan got to be set free. That is terrible. Terrible. But you are totally, totally free in Jesus' name. So you just give him praise and you give him glory. Okay?
Amen.
All right now. All right. Next time when you email me, I'm looking for some good news.
Yes. Amen.
Okay. All right. Have a blessed
day.
All right, then.
You too.
All
right. Bye.